What's up, guys? Loki619, and I've got a different kind of video for you today. Today, this is more of like a product review. In this case, more of like an app review, or one of those little reviews that people do when they buy something and then they want to talk about it. But anyhow, the reason I'm reviewing an app today, and the app's called AstroPad, is because of this little guy right here. Not the blank space that you see on this web browser, but this guy right here, the Wacom tablet, or the Wacom Cintiq 22 HD. What this is basically is that this is a digitizing tablet where you pretty much draw on the screen, and what you draw is what you see on whatever application you're using, like Photoshop, Illustrator, or whatever. And it's a great little tool for those of you that like to draw, like to doodle, and you know, like to create art. Now, one of the things you guys don't know about me is many, many years ago when I decided to come back to San Diego, the reason I came back to San Diego is because of the fact that I wanted to become a comic book artist. And I did a lot of drawing, I did a lot of doodling, and the thing is that this thing cost 2.2 million won. No, it's not won. Won is the Korean currency. Let's go to Google right here. This isn't Google. Let's go to Amazon and look it up. So it's the Cintiq 22 HD, and it cost on Amazon $1,999.95. This thing is freaking expensive. So I didn't want to spend close to $2,000, a little over $2,000 plus tax. They have to put in the tax. So I got an app called AstroPad. Basically, what AstroPad does is it turns your Mac and your iPad into somewhat of the equivalent of a Cintiq. Now, right here is AstroPad, and basically it's installed on both my Mac as well as my iPad. And basically what it does is it allows me to draw on the iPad, or doodle on the iPad, or draw on the iPad as if I was drawing like on a Cintiq digitizing tablet. But the only difference is that this is an iPad. Now, is it a direct replacement for Cintiq? No. I mean, this thing is $24.99 as far as, you know, the price is concerned versus $1,999.95 plus $175 in estimated tax for this Cintiq. But $25 is a much better price to pay versus $2,000 for something that I'm not even sure that I'm going to be, you know, able to dedicate a whole lot of time to. I just wanted something that I could pull, you know, my iPad, start doodling and get the job done. So who knows? I mean, will I be able to do something with it? I don't know. We'll see. Now, what I can do is this. I can zoom in, start drawing little lines over here and, you know, on different layers and whatnot. And yeah, I can start doodling. And it's great because it works just like, you know, like I was drawing directly on the iPad. And the thing about the iPad is, yeah, you can draw on the iPad without this $25 app, but the thing is, you're drawing on the iPad and it looks kind of, I don't know, you're drawing on like little applications that are on the iPad that don't always have a direct desktop translation or direct desktop version. So for example, 52 pages and a bunch of other apps out there, you have to export them as a JPEG, a PNG file, you know, whatever else format you're exporting them as. Whereas with this, I can work directly in Adobe Photoshop and, you know, have access to layers, have access to brushes, have access to all the different things that I normally would use when I'm doodling in Adobe Photoshop. Now, I can also use Illustrator, which I'm not going to fire up right now simply because I'm a little pressed for time, as well as simply for the fact that Illustrator is not exactly the best. I mean, this app does not exactly work very well on Illustrator because of the fact that Illustrator has a little bit of a hover function that doesn't quite get picked up on this app, because you can't really actually hover over certain items as you would in Illustrator. So instead, I'm just gonna go ahead and play in Photoshop with this particular review and go from there. So as I mentioned earlier, we're looking at a blank screen right here. The movement between, you know, going from one part of the image to another part is somewhat sluggish, because you have to actually go to your iPad and with two, you know, multi-finger gestures move the actual canvas so that you can draw on it and do certain things. Like for example, right over here. And the nice thing about it though is that it is so relatively lag-free. So these circles right here, I'm making them on the iPad as if, and it's appearing on my screen, and this is what I'm recording right now, is the screen on my iMac. And it's working just fine, you know, and you can undo all the changes that you make, etc., etc. So, you know, it's a great app so far for those of you that don't want to spend $2,000 on a Cintiq 22 HD. but again, it's not quite as antique. Now, I'm gonna hold off on doing an actual doodle or a full-blown doodle simply because of the fact that I don't have my stylus. The stylus that I do have, for some reason, stopped working. It's an old stylus. I don't know what the deal is with this thing, but it hasn't worked in a while. So I'm using my finger right now. I should have a stylus coming in tomorrow that has a little more of a precise tip to it. And that's another thing too with this program or this little app is that it works with Bluetooth pressure sensitive styluses that you can use on your iPad. I'm pretty sure that this app, when it was made, was written with the iPad Pro in mind, but the problem with the iPad Pro is that I don't have one. And you know, if I had the money to buy one for $1,900, I much go rather just get a Cintiq instead of an iPad Pro. At least with the Cintiq, I can switch between my Mac and my PC, between the Windows computing and Mac OS X computing environments, and just, you know, flip flop as needed. Whereas with the iPad Pro, I'm somewhat limited to, you know, to the platform that I can. I mean, I know I can use them both, but you know, it's one of those things where you're kind of stuck. Now, one of the things I like doing is changing the color of when I'm doing like line work. I'll start off with like a light blue like this right here, like almost like a sky blue. And the reason I do that is because when I used to doodle on paper, I used to use a non-photographic blue pencil. Basically what it is it's a blue pencil that when you photocopy the paper, the blue pencil doesn't show up. Nowadays, with sensors being as sensitive as they are, yeah, it's gonna show up. But back in the day, I used to use blue for the, like, just outlining or roughing up the sketch and things like that. So you see the circle right over here? Yeah, this, when you photocopy this, it normally does not show up in the final product. And what does show up are the blue lines, or the black lines. Speaking of black lines, let's go draw something. What am I drawing? Batman. Is this Batman? Is it Batman?
Is this the Batman that we need, or the Batman that we want? Let's draw Batman. Is it Batman? You think it's Batman? Yes, I wanted to be a comic book artist. This is Batman. Why do I sound like freaking Bane? I don't know. But is this Batman? Oh, just wait and see. Is this Batman? No, I don't think it's Batman. It's not Batman. No. Who is it? Oh, what is that? Is that Batman's eye? Why is it in the middle of his face? Oh, there's his eyes. He's got two of them.
No, this isn't Batman. This is a pig. We're just doodling here. Just a little pig. But to make this pig doodle complete, we want to put a little bow tie on him so he's nice and cute, little piggy. Hello, little piggy. Hello, it's me, your friend Lurky. Lurky's drawing you. And put a little tail on your butt. All right, so that's a little piggy with a butt tail, and there we go. So that said, we're gonna wait. What happened here? Ah, man, we drew it directly on the background. We should have drawn it on a separate layer, and I think I deleted that layer earlier when I deleted. Yep, I deleted it earlier. So we should have started another layer altogether to draw the line work on this, so that we could go back and just very quickly outline, you know, trace over in black. So that, you know, and then we can hide this layer, the rough lines, and then just leave the black layers, the black lines out for people to see. Dang it. All right, let's try it again. So we're going to start over from the very beginning. Bye-bye, Mr. Piggy. That was at first Batman. We thought you were going to be Batman, but you turned out to be a little piggy. See you later, Mr. Piggy. I'm going to miss you, Mr. Piggy. Bye-bye, Mr. Piggy. Okay, delete. Where's the delete button here? There we go. No, that's not how you delete it. Mr. Piggy, we're still there. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and start a couple of new layers here. Have a new background. I'm going to get rid of Mr. Piggy here. Mr. Piggy, get out of here. There we go. Bye-bye, Mr. Piggy. So Mr. Piggy's gone. We're gonna go ahead and, okay, add two, three. Okay, so one of them is gonna be the background. We're gonna fill that with white. As soon as we can figure out how to fill this in white. Where's our paint? There we go. No, that's the wrong button. Get over there. That's another thing, guys. It doesn't, you know, when you're switching between tools and features and windows and things like that on the iPad, you've got a very limited real estate, so you're working on a really small screen. So you're going back and forth, and it does take a while to, you know, switch between tools and settings and things like that. So, and that's one thing you gotta consider. Where's the Cintiq? Yeah, you're spending $2,000, it's going to save you a little bit of time because you'll have all the different buttons that you can program on the side that will allow you to go to, you know, different parts of Photoshop, etc. on the fly. Whereas with this one, again, you're just pretty much going back and forth with multi-finger gestures to zoom in and out, move the canvas left, move the canvas right, etc., etc. So that said, we're going to go ahead and continue our drawing. And back from, due to popular demand, we've got Mr. Piggy. He's coming back from the dead.
Mr. Piggy shall rise again. He shall rise again and be back for more to fight crime and eat slop from his piggy trough. Here we go, Mr. Piggy. Let's give you a nose. Today we'll give you a nose and some eyes. Yes, big fat piggy eyes and a big fat piggy nose. Put your fine details in, Mr. Piggy. Yes, Mr. Piggy's kind of mad because we deleted him the first time. Now he's back again. And again, what we're doing basically is we're drawing Mr. Piggy on a separate layer. And we have to put Pig there just in case you guys don't really know he's Pig and you think that he's Batman or something. So, we're gonna, again, we've drawn the rough parts of Mr. Piggy. Mr. Piggy's all kinds of rough on a layer using blue ink. And what we're going to do next is draw him again. We're going to add another layer. And this time what we're going to do is use the blue ink lines, or the blue pencil lines, or is that right? Pencil lines. The blue strokes. We're going to use the blue strokes as a guide. And what we'll do is we'll go over with black and just kind of, you know, maybe make the brush a little bit bigger. We also want to change the opacity as well as the flow. Earlier we set it to a little bit lower than 100%. And then again, we're going to go back and just trace over the blue outlines that we, or the blue lines that we did earlier. That way we give Mr. Piggy some life. Now, I don't have time to do this now, and I'm probably not going to do it now, but what I eventually will do, or what normally happens after this, is I'll add a few more layers to establish like the base color, and then some of the other details, the highlights, etc., etc., and we'll go from there. But again, I don't really have a whole lot of time to do that right now, so I'm just going to concentrate on doing the line art for Mr. Piggy. Mr. Piggy. Now, once again, guys, I'm doing this with my finger, with the finger in the world. Wait, that's not how that song goes. So I'm doing it with my finger. But ideally I'd like to be doing this with a stylus, and I think what I'll do is the next time I do another doodle, once I get my precise stylus in the mail, I'll do another doodle and we'll go from there. This time we'll add a little belly button because Mr. Piggy doesn't have a belly button, and he had a there we go, a little tail. And then we will finish it off by writing pig. So there you go, guys. This again is AstroPad for the iPad and for the Mac. Unfortunately, it does not work for Windows. So if you are looking for a Windows solution, there isn't one right now, which kind of sucks because I am slowly trying to transition from the Windows environment to the, from the Mac environment to the Windows computing environment, since that's where I do most of my YouTube videos anyway. But for now, it looks like I am kind of still stuck, and for the next $25, this is what I'll be using until hopefully I can save up some money to be able to get away from AstroPad and go onto the actual Cintiq. But it's still $2,000. Anyhow, guys, thank you so much for showing up tonight and watching this video. This is Loki619. I will catch you guys later.